Hi, welcome to Flights of Fancy Storytime. I'm Ann from the National Air and Space Museum, and I'm here to bring some of our museum stories to you at home. I like to keep up with space news and stories about rockets and spaceships. Here at the National Air and Space Museum, we are always excited when we launch another spacecraft to Mars, like the Perseverance rover. We've sent other rovers to Mars, and we've learned so much about the planet with each mission. We have test models from each of these missions at the museum for people to see. The first rover, Sojourner, was small and it had 6 wheels. Can you see the bumps on the wheels? That would help it grip to Mars ground. It had a solar panel on the top that could get power from the sun. Then, Spirit and Opportunity were the next to go up. These twin explorers were a bit bigger. They had 6 wheels to help them move around. They have a camera on the top part that took really good pictures, like this one of the Martian sunset. Next was Curiosity, which was even bigger and had even better cameras and equipment. It still had 6 wheels, but now the rover could dig in the Mars dirt and do tests on the soil and rocks. And now the next rover is Perseverance. The Perseverance rover was launched in a rocket July 30th, 2020, and then traveled through space in a special spacecraft that protects the rover and can take it down to the planet. The Perseverance rover is an amazing vehicle with wheels, cameras, microphones, and science equipment. It will travel on the planet to continue to help us learn more about Mars. One exciting thing that the rover will do is look for evidence of past life on Mars. This would be tiny microbes, not big green aliens. The rover will collect rock and soil samples, do tests, and search for fossils. This means that the Perseverance rover is like a Martian paleontologist. Paleontologists study fossils to learn about past life, usually on Earth. Another super fun experiment that is planned is the launch of the Mars helicopter. We'll see if the helicopter can fly in the Mars air. Mars air is lighter than Earth air, so the aircraft has to be designed a little differently. If helicopters can fly on Mars, they could be used to explore more ground and send more information back to scientists here on Earth. I'll be so interested to find out what happens with these new Mars explorations. It's fun to really dive deep into one topic and learn all about it. Here's a story about that. Once upon a time, there was a little boy named Mo who loved adventures. Everywhere that Mo went, his dog Barkley followed along. Mo liked climbing on fences, asking questions, finding good stuff to make other things with, and most of all, Mo liked his sister Millie. His sister Millie and her friends were always up to something fun and exciting. Lots of times, Millie, Ruth, and Lou played with Mo. Mo remembered one day when Millie, Ruth, and Lou built a rocket to Mars. Mo had brought a blue tarp for the dome that they planned to build on the planet. Ever since that day, Mo had become interested in Mars. He went to the library and took out lots of books about Mars. He learned lots of neat facts about the planet, and when he got back from the library, he wanted to tell Millie about them. He went to find Millie, who was painting an outer space picture with Ruth and Lou. "Hey, Millie," said Mo, "did you know that Mars has the tallest mountain in the solar system?" But sometimes, Millie didn't want Mo around. Millie said, "Go away, Mo. I'm busy right now. I'm painting a picture of a planet that's not even in our solar system." So Mo and Barkley went to play in the sandbox. Mo pushed the sand around and formed a huge mountain out of the sand. He said to Barkley, "The mountain is called Olympus Mons, and it's a volcano. It's 16 miles high, which is much higher than the tallest volcano on Earth." Barkley sniffed the volcano and sat down next to it. Mo dug a big, long hole in the sand. He told Barkley, "Mars also has a big canyon called Valles Marineris." The next day, Mo went online to learn more about Mars. He saw a video about Mars meteorites. He had to tell Millie. He found Millie on her scooter with Ruth and Lou. "Hey, Millie," he shouted. Ruth said, "Millie, Mo is calling you." Millie said, "Can't stop, gotta scoot." So Mo and Barkley went back to the sandbox. Mo dug in the sand. Barkley dug too. Mo found an interesting looking rock. Maybe it was a Martian meteorite. Mo told Barkley, "Meteorites are rocks that fall to Earth from space. Some of the rocks come from Mars." He put it in its pocket for further study. The next day, Mo heard a news story about the new rover being sent to Mars. He heard that the spaceship would have a rover and a helicopter in it. He was so excited he wanted to tell Millie. Millie was eating breakfast and reading a comic book. Millie, did you know that NASA is planning to send a new rover called Perseverance to Mars? Millie said, Mars, Mars, Mars. That's all you ever talk about. You're Mo the Mars Man. Mo walked away. He thought, Mo the Mars Man. I like that. Mo went to play in the sandbox. He pushed a toy excavator around in the sand. He said to Barkley, I'm Mo the Mars Man. This is my new rover. It has a camera, a microphone, and it can dig and collect rocks and sand. The rover is going to make piles of rocks that scientists can find and study later. Perseverance is going to search for fossils on Mars. They might find tiny aliens. Millie walked slowly up. What were you saying, Mo? I'm sorry, I wasn't listening. Oh, said Mo, NASA is sending a really cool new rover to Mars. Millie sat down and started to dig in the sand. Oh, wow. Tell me more, Mars Man. Mo grinned. That was him, Mo the Mars Man. It's craft time. Today we're going to make some sandboxes that you can play with, or some little sensory boxes. And these are just little mini ones. You might have a big sandbox at home, but most of us don't have one. So this is a way that you can have the same kind of experience. This is my sandbox that I made. And I repurposed a plastic container that was from a Crackers, but you can collect different plastic containers and put your sensory materials in it. For this one, I added some kinetic sand in it, which is a really fun kind of material that squishes together a little bit. And then you can also move it around and play with it. And I have a little fun excavator toy to put in there to play in my sandbox. Now you can use a lot of different kinds of materials, and I'll show you another sandbox that I made. So here's my sandbox that I made with my little excavator in it. How fun it is to roll my excavator around and dig a little bit. Maybe make a big Martian volcano over here with my sand. If you don't have sand, another thing you can use is some cornmeal. So I just poured some cornmeal in this takeout container, and then I actually added some little rocks in there to dig up and have some different materials, some different things to use to dig in the sand, like these spoons. And I even found some tongs that were fun. Oh, I think I found something. Oh, what could that be? The last sandbox is not really sand, but it's another material called oobleck, which is really fun to try to make. This material is really weird, and when you play with it, it's kind of like half a liquid, and also kind of has qualities of being solid when you squish it together. Super fun to play with. So what you need to use to make that, again, is a plastic container. And then you're going to need some cornstarch. And here I have a little bit more than a half a cup of cornstarch. And I have a quarter cup of water. I put a little bit of food coloring in the water just for fun. If you put food coloring in, you might dye your hands a little bit. So you can also just make it without the food coloring. So first I'm gonna pour that cornstarch into my plastic container. And I'm gonna sort of spread it around. That cornstarch itself is kind of fun to play with. It has a real soft kind of feeling to it. So you can feel what that feels like all by itself. And then I'm gonna pour the water in. It's really fun. I'm gonna show you one more time on my camera from the other side. Here's the oobleck that you just can mix the cornstarch in with the water, the colored water, and it is kind of like in between a liquid and a solid. It's really messy and fun to play with, and definitely recommend you try it out, each of these different sandboxes. Well, enjoy getting your hands into some of those different sensory materials and have fun. Bye-bye.